Well, I'm sure I'm going to get some shit from this from somebody, but this is the way I do it. As I'm sure the title states something along the lines of how I paint new headers. Well, I like to come out here at 6 o'clock in the morning and everybody's still asleep, dealing with Saturday's hangover. This is how I do it. Propane tank. And see how that instantly flashes? It looks wet. Burn that off. Map gas is faster, but map gas is expensive. It looks like a power washing video. Okay, so somebody's gonna say, well, that high temp paint isn't gonna hold up, or the factory paint, and it won't. But this propane torch doesn't get hot enough to burn it off. We'll get to the paint that I use in a second. Probably missing everything. I hate wearing this head thing, but I can't find my tripod. So the only way I can see what I'm doing is to roll my eyes up in my head. It's funny because what I'm doing here is a little bit Uncle Tony and a little bit of the online argument between the internet people and the cable TV people. But this trick here is a mixture of Uncle Tony and Steve Dulcich. And you'll see why Steve Dulcich in just a second. All right. No, it's not that I'm badass, it's just the headers aren't hot. But, like I said, the propane torch doesn't get it hot enough to burn the paint off. All it does is flash it off. I did this to the headers that are in my black truck, and it worked great. Tank's starting to freeze up. See? Nozzle gets cold. Alright. Then you take your super cheap Walmart brake crangler. Brake clean. And as the liberals would say, apply just enough. As the conservatives would say, apply liberally. And actually, the brake clean's optional. Because most of these times, the headers are clean. I mean, because they clean them before they paint them. It doesn't do them any good to put paint on them and have all the paint roll off or fall off or not stick, whatever. Granted, the paint they put on these is about a joke, but keeps them from rusting. So this here might make some people nervous. So I'll put the really explosive stuff away. Again, flash it off with a torch. I don't care how the finish looks. I don't care that it's burning the bed of the truck. Now, I'm sure some of you think I'm insane. Fine. But, within reason, the hotter the surface, the better the paint adheres, and the better the finish turns out. That is a Steve Dulcich trick. And like any spray paint, you dust it. Your first couple coats are just dust. Just enough to see some color. If it looks nice, you're putting too much paint on. And the cool thing about paint like this, that paint's already dry. So like when this boob drives by in his minivan, then the dust that comes off of his vehicle isn't even going to stick to my paint. Because as soon as it goes on, the paint's dry. So that first coat that I just put on is already dry. It's already gone. It's already set. See the fish eyes and the drips? That's from the brake clean. I don't usually use the brake clean, but just make sure if you're going to use the brake clean that it drips down to where you won't be able to see it, if that makes sense. If I would have sprayed brake clean this way, it would have dripped down on the face of the headers and then you would see it, and that'll never go away. And if you know anything about headers, you so much as put a handprint on these things, as soon as they get hot, that fingerprint, handprint, whatever, will burn into the tubes. And it'll never go away. Unless you repaint them. So, for you guys that are watching this going, ha ha, I've got ceramic coated headers. Cool. Those are nice. Nice and expensive. But if your vehicle drips oil, or if your valve covers leak, or if you have dirty hands when you're installing them, yeah, your ceramic headers now have your forensic evidence on them. I mean, hey, I'm all about fancy stuff. I love it. But these are $270 worth of headers. Well, I guess $285 after tax, but we'll say $300 worth of headers and an $8 can of paint. And really the only part that I care about that looks nice is the part you can see when you open the hood, which is going to be from about here up, or here up. I don't know if you can see my hand or not. I probably shot this whole video looking at my feet, but I hope not. But as anybody that's watching this knows, or any of my subscribers, by the way, feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. Like this video so I can get some ideas what you guys like, so I can put some more content out for you. But anybody that is already subscribed knows that I'm not a professional videographer. I'm a machine, or well, machine operator. I'm not a machine. Arnold Schwarzenegger is a machine. Back when he was cool doing cool movies. Now he's a liberal. A confused liberal. We need to worry about climate change while he drives the biggest vehicle ever made. And I don't know why. I don't know why he's compensating. If anybody ever watched the very beginning of Terminator, the first one, before he goes and steals that dude's clothes, he got quite the hammer hanging, so I don't know why he's compensating. Who knows? But it'd be nice if he'd shut his mouth like Kevin Bacon, you know? Kevin Bacon's got himself a hammer swinging. He doesn't talk about anything. Take some advice. Anyhow, we are done. Ew, look at the shit that's inside those headers. I just got that out of the collector. Guess we'll have to dump a little schmoo down inside the pipes. There we go, a little touch off. That looks nice. And that is what I'm using. I've had good luck with this stuff. Heat resistant silver. It's not bad. Okay, now here's the next part. This is where everybody's gonna get all panicky. Yep, you're back to the torch again. Just burn it. I just chase the pipe as much as I can. Like I said, the main part that I'm worried about is what you can see. Because I'm sure you guys are like, yeah, I know, I wish I could see what you're talking about. But somebody doesn't know how to run a camera or shit. There. Okay, that's right in the middle of my forehead. But the main part that I care about is what you can see. And believe it or not, get it hot with this torch, and it just lays this stuff down. It gets all nice and smooth and glassy looking. Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to see where my camera's pointing. I had a fisheye, but it looked terrible, so I think I threw him away. Got a little cheap kit off Amazon for recording my RC car stuff, and I couldn't see shit with it. I guess I got a minute to do a quick little review on these. This is the only welding spatter I see, is that little ball right there. That's pretty nice. I mean, the flanges are decent inside. Can you see? Maybe. Those aren't too bad. I've seen some old blackjack headers. They look like a 3-year-old welded them, but I suppose that's a possibility. It may have been a 3-year-old in China making them. Who knows? But Okay. Now, I did that exact procedure on these headers when I painted these headers black. Same paint, same Rust-Oleum paint, but it was black grill paint instead of the silver. And this was 3 years ago I painted these. No rust. There we go. Little bit of rust right up on the flanges themselves, but great, the autofocus was turned off again. I'm sorry. So, anyhow, I'm sure when I pop this thing, I was going to shut the camera off. Oh, no, guess not. That one's turned out pretty nice. They're not perfect. They don't need to be. They're headers. They're going to get all beat up and dinged up on the way in the truck anyway, so. Well, let's hope they fit, and I'll report how well they or how long they last. So, I'll see you in the next one, guys.